Good afternoon. I'm Meredith Reynolds, the Park Development Officer for the Department of Parks, Recreation, and Marine. I'd like to welcome you to the grand opening of the new playground today at Drake Park. Thank you for coming. I'd like to recognize a few special guests here today. Please welcome Pat West, City Manager. Thank you. Our Parks and Recreation Commissioners, Zanata, Salgado, and Morales. Thank you guys for coming today. I'd like to acknowledge Mark Taylor, Chief of Staff for Mayor Garcia, as well as Tyler Curry and Jennifer Kumiyama from the First District Council Office. A big thank you to Eric Lopez and Adrian Pavone from Public Works for their hard work on the project. And a big high five for Gladys Ashley and the Drake Park Community Center staff. Today's grand opening follows those at Jackson Park Playground, Los Cerritos Park Playground, Veterans Park Playground, and Whaley Park Playground. It's quite a mouthful. And continues the city's investment in unique play spaces designed and themed to capture imagination at play. To kick off our celebration today, please welcome Mark Taylor, Chief of Staff for Mayor Garcia.
Good morning, and or actually, good afternoon, and welcome everyone. I bring greetings from Mayor Garcia, who's actually on a lovely turquoise beach in Turks and Caicos right now with Matt celebrating his honeymoon. So he really wishes he could be, well, I don't know, maybe he does. Maybe he's probably very happy where he is, but he was bound to, you know, he really wanted to make sure that someone was here from his office to celebrate this exciting achievement. Where did it just go? Oh, blew over. There we go. Thank you. So we're continuing to rebuild Long Beach thanks to voter support of Measure A. This is the, you know, we've done over two dozen major park improvements as a result of Measure A, and this is the fourth new park playground. That's hard to say. And we just recently opened one at Willow Park. This is number five. We have one more to go. I'm incredibly excited about this. As you can see, it has a wonderful butterfly theme, and it really captures the feeling of this lovely neighborhood. So I'd like to thank the director, the Department of Parks, Recreation, Marine, Department of Public Works, and everybody on the city team who worked to see this project through. And with that, it's my pleasure to turn this back to Meredith, who's going to bring up our councilwoman.
Please welcome to the podium First District Councilwoman Lena Gonzalez.
Thank you so much. Good afternoon, everybody. How's everyone doing today? In the rain. Thank you for braving the rain. It's really important that we're here. And I want to start this off by saying that in my 10 years in public service with the city of Long Beach, almost 10 years will be this year, as I look back and see this beautiful park, playground, I think of not only my children, but so many children in Willmar and around Drake that get the opportunity to do this and to experience this. So let's give all of you, the parents, the commissioners, which I'll address, and all of the Willmore and Drake and CPC and all of the amazing nonprofits and people that have made this happen, let's give yourselves a round of applause. If it wasn't for you, this would not happen. So I'd also like to take a moment to thank our new director of Parks, Recreation, and Marine, Gerardo Moe, and his team, Director of Public Works, Craig Beck, and as well as Chief of Staff, Mark Taylor, for being here, representing our mayor, who is in the beautiful Turks and Caicos. Additionally, thank you to the First District Representative for the Parks, Recreation, and Marine Commission, Commissioner Mariela Salgado. Both her, as well as Commissioner David Zanata, worked together to improve the quality of life for many parks and many residents here. I'd also like to address Drake Park Supervisor Kevin Pimeni, is he here as well? And of course, our city manager, Pat West. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you as well. We're just gonna give everyone a round of applause today. And additionally, the Willmore City Heritage Association, we have Jim and Kathleen. I've made you one today. Kathleen Irvine, Jim Dano, Julian Tyler, Terry Beebe, Teresa Calloway. We have Diane McNinch here, Isaac Salgado, Jenny Sertian, and so many others. And Ernie, I see all of you here. Sheila, I can name so many. Your commitment to making this a better park for our families is so much that we have to be thankful for you. So not only is this a fantastic new modern park, but it's in the city's oldest and most historic neighborhoods, the birthplace of Long Beach. It has evolved so much and would be unrecognizable in comparison to its original state when it was founded in 1904. The land was donated to the city by the park's namesake, Charles Drake, who operated the former Virginia Hotel in downtown Long Beach. And what used to be a passive park eventually gained a community center, soccer field, and much more. And as the park continued to expand, tennis courts were added behind the Bembridge House. And last January, almost a year ago, we opened the long-anticipated Drake Chavez Greenbelt to link Chavez and Loma Vista Park, and we also opened an artificial turf field at Drake. Thanks to a $1 million investment from Measure A today, we are celebrating the opening of a playground that is truly one of a kind. It's a butterfly garden theme. This playground definitely contributes to the uniqueness of Drake Park and the Wilmore neighborhood. And I look forward to seeing not only my children again, but your children too, and our grandchildren down the road, to make sure that they're loving this for years to come. So I'd like to welcome back Meredith back to the podium, and thank you again all for being here. It's truly remarkable to be celebrating this, and I hope that the next phase will certainly be, and I know we're still working on the community center, but I hope we can continue working on the community center and so many improvements here at Drake. Thanks again.
And now I'd like to please welcome to the podium Eric Lopez, Project Management Manager from the Department of Public Works, representing Craig Beck today.
Thank you, Meredith. Good afternoon. On behalf of Craig Beck, our Director of Public Works, I'd like to thank you for joining us today as we celebrate the opening of this latest playground. Public Works gets the opportunity to plan, design, and construct wonderful projects like these throughout the entire city. This specific playground was designed to provide opportunities for physical, social, emotional, sensory, cognitive, and communicative development. And you all thought your kids were just playing. We've improved the landscaping. We've added new benches, new trash cans. We've made some improvements to the walkways. And by delivering this process, we're also able to help divert almost 5,000 pounds of rubber that would have ended up in our landfills by using them for the rubberized surface. These types of projects would not be possible without the hard work of the many, many team members that it takes to deliver them. From our planners, to our designers, to our park staff, to our maintenance crews, to the engineers and the project managers, they all have to get together, work together, help ensure that all the pieces work well to be able to deliver wonderful projects like these. And so to them, I'd like to say thank you. I'd like to especially thank the designer, Hurston Associates, the contractor, Harry Joe, the subcontractor, Child's Play, and our very own project manager, Adrian Pavone. Thank you for your hard work. With that, I'd like to bring back Meredith.
Thank you, Eric. I'll finish up here by taking on the talking points from our director, Gerardo Moet. He is unfortunately out ill today. So on behalf of him, as well as the rest of our department, we find a lot of fun in creating play spaces that are unique to the neighborhood and to our community. And as you see behind me, we have something really fantastic, really bright and colorful that is representative of many of the historic homes with the front yards that have butterfly gardens here in the community. The playground here has two new accessible playground structures, one for 2 to 5 year olds and one from 5 to 12 year olds. We have the play space, we have the swings, we have the rubberized surface that Eric spoke about. Everything here really got a refresh and it looks fantastic. This is really helpful in getting the kids of our community to come out and to play. Our goal is they walk out of their home, they turn the corner, they see something bright and engaging, and they can't wait to run and play on this playground. And we think we really hit the nail on the head today, and we're really proud of it for us, and we're really proud of it for you. The project cost almost $945,000, which was made possible by Measure A. And thank you for your faith and selecting those funds for us here for this playground, as well as some grant sources that were able to help buy down the cost of the playground equipment so we could improve just that much more here at the playground. I'm very excited for the community to experience this bright and engaging new play space. And so without further ado, I'd like to call up Mark Taylor, the councilwoman, your friends, your neighbors, to cut the ribbon. And while I do that, we have some very special fairies fluttering around our playground today for your children to come by and say hi to and play with. So that'll be a lot of fun. So please join me and let's cut the ribbon. Thank you. Yay!